Hi, I'm Marko from the Grainfather software development team, and today we'll be talking about mIBU. Specifically, what is mIBU and how does it benefit the brewer? But first, let's quickly review what's an IBU. Before international bitterness units, or IBUs, came along, it was difficult to put a number to how bitter your beer was. The IBU scale was introduced in the 1950s as a way to put a number to this perception of bitterness. Today's homebrewers benefit from the IBU as a tool when formulating recipes and maintaining bitterness in regularly brewed beers. However, it's important to remember that the IBU does not reflect the quality or the overall perception of the bitterness. So, what is mIBU? The mIBU method was developed by Paul Hosum in 2015. Based on the Tinsith equation, it includes many optimizations which makes it better suited for the beers we brew today. How does it work? Basically, it calculates what your wort temperature and volume will be throughout the boil, hop stand, and cooling stages. The algorithm then steps through and calculates the instantaneous IBU based on the temperature and volume at that time. Finally, it adds up all the results to get the total IBU contribution. Sounds complicated, right? Check out our blog post for more information on mIBU. Now we're going to do a quick demo of the mIBU feature. So first of all, you want to make sure mIBU is selected as your chosen bitterness formula. You can do that in the preferences page. Next, we'll have a quick look at the equipment. We've added a few new parameters for the equipment profile. Down at the bottom there, we've got cooling method and cooling method related parameter, like flow rate if you've got a counterflow chiller, exponential decay factor if you've got immersion chiller or an ice bath, and we've also added a kettle diameter field to help us estimate the natural decay. Now, I've prepared a quick example recipe. It's an ale. It's got two hop additions, one at 60 minutes and one at 10 minutes. So you can see on the mIBU graph, you can see how those hops contribute bitterness over time. You can also see during that cooling stage, it's contributing less as the wort temperature gets lower. So I'll change that 10 minute to a 5 minute. You can see straight away the graph updates. And then if I change it to a 0 minute, it actually moves that whole bitterness contribution into the cooling section of the chart. You can toggle the different hops on and off, so you can see for each hop where is it contributing. And you could also see for that 60 minute hop, even in the cooling stage, it's got some contributions there. Still show you how the equipment cooling parameter affects the IBU calculation. So to do that, when you go up to the top and select a different equipment profile, we'll start with the immersion chiller one. Once I've got that selected, the chart will redraw, so you can now see that cooling method, the wort temperature actually drops a lot faster as the immersion chiller cools the wort down, and as a result there's a lower IBU contribution for that hop. And then if I change it to a no-chill equipment, you can see it's going to take 120 minutes for it to cool down. During that time, there's a lot more bitterness being contributed, and you can see that on the chart as well. Switch back to the counterflow chiller for the next example. So what I'll do is I'll change this hop to a hop stand. I'll give it a time, a hop stand time, and then you'll see on the chart there's now that extra hop stand section. You can play around with different temperature. You can see if it changes the temperature, then the wort temperature on the chart will update and the corresponding bitterness contributions. If you change that down to 7 degrees, you can see the cooling down to 7 degrees results in a lot less bitterness contributions for that hop. So with this, you're able to get much more accurate bitterness predictions throughout the hop stand based on your hop stand temperature. As you can see, mIBU is a great new way to calculate your IBU contributions. Try it for yourself today by downloading our free Grainfather app or visit the website.